Thank you. To the Majestic Theater in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. My name is Steve Marx, and I am honored to take the helm of the Sunderman Conservatory Wind Symphony while my esteemed colleague, Dr. Russell McCutcheon, is on sabbatical. A word about the piece you just heard. Joan Tower's Celebration Fanfare is the last movement from her score to the ballet Stepping Stone. The composer notes that the fanfare's rising motif is fitting to the progressive stages of a woman's development, which is the theme of the ballet. Next on the program is Catherine Sadfelter's Shadows Ablaze, a work that pays homage to the three-voice chanson Dans Notre Ame, written in the late 15th century by Johannes Akagem, who was arguably the most famous composer of the Franco-Flemish school. His music is characterized by memorable lyricism and contrapuntal craft. Sadfelter states of Shadows Ablaze, when quoting a respected composer's work, it is tempting to put his music on a pedestal, to glorify it in the context of one's own new and lesser music. In Shadows Ablaze, the Glockenspiel captures this ideal, illuminating fragments of Akagem's song in its original, unaltered form. However, the surrounding new music that you will soon hear from the ensemble is also from the old chanson, now deconstructed. The tenor reharmonized as the opening low brass chorale, the superior voice inverted and transformed into a descant, and the contratenor re-rhythmatized into woodwind flourishes. These shadows of the chanson, while each traceable to the source, no longer revere their original composer, but rather assume their own identities, permeating every bar of the work. Here is the Gettysburg premiere of Shadows Ablaze.
Ben McCarley. I am a sophomore music education major, and I play the clarinet. When I say Bach, what is the first thing that comes to mind? Is it a German composer? Is it a musician? Or is it a chicken? Well, I mean, it was Chicken Finger Friday today. Maybe you better call Bullet to see if they can round up a few extra dinners here and there. But let's focus on the first two for now. Johannes Sebastian Bach was a German composer and musician around the classical era. Around this time, he focused a lot of his music on the secular side, along with the sacred music of the time. Our next piece, Komm süßer Tod, or Come Sweet Death, highlights the aspects of wanting more in life. I know that we've had a lot of troubling times recently with COVID and everything else, so I think this song is a really good representation of what we want in our daily lives now. It's a sense of normalcy, in a sense. And with this song, the original German text highlights a sense of wanting to leave, a sense of wanting to leave to a higher plane, to want to return to that sense of normality. So without further ado, here is Komm süßer Tod.
Thank you. Hi. Good evening, and thank you for being here. Remember me? It's a pleasure to be here with you this evening and a pleasure to share the concert with all of the students and all of you. I have a few thank yous that I need to give. The first is I would like to thank my colleague and my friend, Steve Marx, for filling in for me this semester, Dr. Marx. I want to extend my thanks to all of the students in the ensemble and all the students in our program for their flexibility. Change is always difficult, but it's also an opportunity to learn different techniques and different things from different people, and that's one of the exciting things that we offer here at Gettysburg College. In addition to thanking all of the students, we need to thank a special group of students. Each year, it's the most bittersweet time, which is graduation, and this will be the final Wind Symphony performance for a group of students. We've worked with them for a long time, and it's always sad to see them go, but it's always exciting to see where they're going to go. So, without any further ado, Dr. Marx, let's thank our seniors.
I can only echo what Dr. McCutcheon had said, and know that your peers, faculty, and family are your biggest supporters. We can't wait to watch the great things that you do in the next chapters of your lives. Please hold applause for everybody at the end. We will announce our seniors in alphabetical order, and please stand as you hear your name. Sophia Bukas, Andrew Buckley, Amanda Carrier, Justin Chavonic, Will Esposito, Sydney Goldberg, Megan Green, Ethan Tessier, Kai Saunders, Blaise Veres, Danny Wallace. Let's give these individuals a warm round of applause.
My name is Katie Earle. I'm a junior German major, music minor, and we are going to be playing our next piece, which is Holst's first suite in E-flat. Gustav Holst was born in England to Adolf Holst, an organist and pianist, and Clara Cox, a singer. As a result of having two musicians as parents, Holst started learning music from an early age. Eventually, trombone became his main instrument because of difficulty playing piano from hand tremors and because his father thought it would help his asthma. This choice ended up determining his musical career as Holst made a living as a trombone player and became famous for composing music for orchestra and wind band. Some of his more famous works include his orchestral suite, The Planets, and First Suite in E-flat for military band. The first movement, Chaconne, opens with an 8-bar melody in the low brass that is heard in different variations throughout. The second movement, Intermezzo, has one rhythmic melody that is introduced by the woodwinds. A variation on this theme is introduced about halfway through, which carries through to the end of the movement. The third movement, March, has two main melodies. The first can be heard at the beginning, played by the brass, the second in the woodwinds. March ends with both melodies layered on top of each other. I hope you enjoy identifying these themes as we play Gustav Holst's first suite in E-flat.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello, my name is Megan McCook, and I am a junior economics major with music and English minors, and I play the trombone. Our final two pieces this evening will be Omnium Mysterium and Shepherd's Hay. Omnium Mysterium was composed by Morten Lauritsen in 1994 and was originally and most well known as a choral piece. The piece was a commission from the Los Angeles Master Chorale, and Lauritsen looked to this painting, Still Life with Lemons, Oranges, and a Rose, from 1633, as well as Gregorian chant for inspiration. He credits the dissonant G-sharp that resolves into a minor triad as the source of the piece's sorrow, but then is followed by a more joyful finale paralleling its Latin text. Shepherd's Hay was composed by Percy Grainger, who is well known for his work involving folk tunes. There are two main ideas passed throughout the ensemble in a bouncy manner. Shepherd's Hay can be accompanied by English folk dancing, which involves light-footed rhythmic steps, as well as the words, I can whistle, I can sing, I can do most anything. Thank you for joining us this evening, and we hope you enjoy our final two pieces.